Hello and welcome to a new episode of Victoria 3 A to Z. Today we are playing in Ethiopia. I'm not gonna lie to you, I never actually played in this region before. But today we are playing one of the weakest and smallest nation here. So I guess we'll see how this goes. Everyone in the region has regular infantry, so I'm thinking I can rush for line infantry and then beat everyone up with my superior army. But that army will need a lot of guns. So I'll be preparing some gun and artillery production. Let's get some tools, one iron mine, and then we'll be making some guns. As for diplomacy, I'll declare rivalry on this guy. And then I'll start improving relations with Egypt, and also with as many Ethiopian nations as I can. I see that I only have 2 units, but my neighbor here also has only 2 units. So if I can build under Berek and get 3 units, maybe I can beat them. But before that, let's get some decrease in our states. Some road maintenance and some social mobility, in both states. Now with the rest of the authority, I'm gonna add some taxes. And for the first law, we're going for professional army. If I'm playing a small nation, I always like to take the prestige from this event. There we go, I already considered the regional power. I have 3 units, so I think I can go ahead and attack this guy. And if nobody joins, I'll be able to annex him. My plan is to go and conquer everyone in Somalia and then go into Ethiopia proper. Shewa sides with them. They are pretty powerful, but they are landlocked, so they can't actually get the front line. Looks like we're not really able to push them. Now they are trying to attack me and I'm pushing them back as well. Let's try another attack. And this time we're beating them, okay. And we got a professional army. I'll go for local police force next. We annex them. But we are still at war with this guy, so I guess we'll need to wait a little bit more until we can finally peace out. Local police force was also enacted. We do have mercantilism, so I think it's probably time to get some corn laws. Let's make sure we export as much grain as possible. Now, grain is very expensive, so corn laws should trigger. Finally, the event triggered, the modern conservative. And now we have a landowner that's a market liberal, so let's make him the leader of the landowners. Let's make sure they are the only people in government. And let's start passing some better laws. Let's go for homesteading. Okay, now let's keep going. Laissez-faire. We can form an alliance with one of our neighbors. So which one do I want? Do I want Harar? Or do I want Wello? I'll go for this guy, because I think I'll expand into Harar later. We got line infantry and laissez-faire unlocked. Now I'll go for some stock exchange. And we can finally peace out with those guys. Now let's change my units to line infantry with some cannon artillery. Now my army is better than everyone else's, so I can start expanding some more. Nobody seems to join, so this war will probably be pretty easy. Now what I could do is get the ulema in charge. And then I can start banning slavery. Let's see if this works. We are destroying those guys with help from our allies. Let's annex you. I think I can keep going. This army is costing a lot of money though. I will annex you as well. And then I'll go for this guy. I'm not even mobilizing anyone for this war. I'll just let my ally do all the work. And the landowners want to rise up in this province that doesn't even have a barrack. So yeah, sure, go for it. And another one is gone. I can't really afford the army, so I guess I'll have to go back to irregulars. Oh no, the revolution started. How many units do they have? 0. That's how many. Easiest civil war of my life. And we officially banned slavery. Now let's get some schools. If I get the taxes up, I can actually afford the line infantry army. This seems like an amazing opportunity. I can join the Customs Union of Britain, or I can even become their protectorate. Let's join their Customs Union. Why not? Look at our balance going up. And you know what? I think I might actually be able to go against Harar. We have well on our side, and also our army is better than theirs. So let's go for it. Looks like absolutely no one wants to get involved in this. And we also got religious schools. I'll try some colonial resettlement. We are destroying them on both fronts. Now let's annex them. Now we're looking a little more powerful. Now I think we can keep going. I will annex this guy next. And they stand no chance against us. They capitulated very fast. The nice thing about the Unify Ethiopia diplomatic play is that you don't need to worry about relations. For example, I have cordial relations with this guy, but I can still use the diplomatic play and annex him. So this guy in the north joined against me, which I don't really like. So for that, I will also annex you. I'll first deal with this guy and then I'll move here. One of them capitulated and the next one will soon follow. Just like I said. Now I have a little bit of infamy, so should I wait until it goes down, or should I keep going? I think I'll keep going. Gorjam joined against us. Now this will be opening a lot of fronts in the north. And also Gorjam has a really big army. But they are irregulars after all, so I think we can beat them. Now the front with Gorjam is not really looking amazing, I'm not gonna lie to you. I think that might have been a little bit too much for our army. Let's start mobilizing everyone. And then we'll see what happens. This is an absolute mess right here. I don't know what's happening anymore. Am I winning? Am I losing? I have absolutely no idea. Now occupying most of their countries and they are occupying most of my country. It's pretty weird. Now we got colonial resettlement. And also one of them capitulated. Now I think I should start getting a colony here, in Kenya. Or in the Rift Valley. Maybe I can get a connection to those guys in the Lake Victoria region. But first, let's finish this war. Now I think it's probably time to unite our land. So let's do this. But of course, those guys are not alone. They've also called in Tigray, which I'm gonna annex as well. Let's annex them. And now I think it may be a good time to break our alliance with Uello. Those guys helped us a lot in our wars, but now they are pretty much useless. Their entire army is dead, so I don't have any use for them anymore. Now let's go ahead and annex Shewa. This time there is no one left to come to their aid. And that's why they'll be annexed. Now there is only one left. There is only Uello. But not for long. We also got protectionism in the meanwhile. And now our former ally will be incorporated into our country. And now we can finally go ahead and click the button. And form Ethiopia. But with that much expanding, we have also accumulated quite a lot of infamy. So I think we'll need to chill for a little while. Oh, and by the way, we don't even have a construction sector yet. Maybe, just maybe, I should build one. And now we unlocked railways. Okay, now we can finally deal with our market access problems. And freedom of conscience was enacted. Let's form a government to the intelligentsia. And let's get some voting. Looks like we can't really get it now without a civil war. So maybe next time. We unlocked skirmish infantry. That's pretty good. But that's gonna cost a lot of money. Britain is colonizing like crazy in this region. I don't think I'll be able to get a connection to those states. We also got appointed bureaucrats now. Let's get a National Guard. And yes, looks like I was cut off from this region. This passed pretty quickly. So I waited for a couple of years and looks like my infamy has mostly disappeared. Now I think it's time for some expansion. I think I could go into Egypt. They definitely have a bigger army than me. But I think my army is better. They are using line infantry with no artillery. Meanwhile, I'm using skirmish infantry with mobile artillery, so I think I can beat them. Let's attack them for Eritrea. And let's start mobilizing absolutely everyone. What I also want to do in this war is to liberate Sudan. This will destroy the Egyptians. And let's also get some more reps. Now I just hope nobody joins. Actually, the Ottomans would like to join me, if I give them Adana. Sure, let's do that. Let's fix the border gore. First battle and we're pushing on the main front. And we already occupy 100% of our war goals. And we also got public schools enacted. And we can enforce our demands. There we go. Now Egypt is way smaller. Now what I would also like to do is get a foothold in Arabia. And this guy has 0 units. So I think you know what I'm gonna do about him. I will annex them. Now let's continue expanding into Yemen. Although that's a lot of infamy. Hejaz also joined against me. So I guess they've chosen their fate. I will annex both of them. Oh, now Britain wants to subjugate Egypt. That's not good. It is historical, but not good. I was hoping I'll be the one to do that. Egypt is now a British dominion. That's very unfortunate. And France is also expanding in Arabia. They already have Nejd. Now they're probably gonna get Jabal Shamar. I think I should also expand into the Arabian nations before France conquers them all. So I will attack this guy. Let's annex you. But before I attack this nation, I would like to vassalize Sudan. The Ottoman Empire might side with them. But I think I can do it. Yes, it looks like we're fighting the Ottomans. But we're pushing in the Sudanese capital. And that's what matters. And Sudan capitulated. Now we're only at war with the Ottomans. Now we also got per capita taxation. Finally we can end this war. Now let's continue the Arabian expansion. Let's do this. Now I think I will vassalize Oman. The Ottomans want to go to war again. But this time I'll make sure I actually punish them. I will make them release Syria. And Iraq. Oman is already in default. Oman capitulated. Now let's make a naval invasion in the Ottoman capital. We landed unopposed. Let's dismantle the Ottoman Empire. That's what you get for not minding your own business. Now I will attack Bahrain next. I will annex Bahrain and then I will wait a little bit until my infamy goes down. Now I think it's a good time to annex Sudan. Sudan will join my empire. And it's also time for Oman to be integrated. Okay, Oman backs down. And they were annexed. Now I will attack and annex Darfur. Goodbye, Darfur. Now that's a nice Ethiopia. Now we got public health insurance for all citizens. What's exactly happening in the British Empire? They are at war with this guy. And he managed to conquer all of British Africa. In the meanwhile, I've become a major power. And I can also form a defensive pact with Italy. The Ethiopian-Italian alliance. Let's do it. Now something very interesting just happened. France is about to start a huge war against Siam and Austria. I think it's a very good opportunity for me to also attack France and take over their Arabian puppets. But I will start a play in France for recognition because somebody else might join. Looks like nobody wants to join me apart from Italy, which wants an obligation, which I can't give them. But it also seems like the French are not defending their puppets. They are probably too busy in Europe. I made sure I also added all the war goals I wanted. The war started and we are walking into Arabia completely unopposed. We already occupy 100% of our war goals. I occupied all their holdings here. Now I just need to hold all this land and make sure they don't try a naval invasion on me. France is in a civil war, so I think we're fine. They agree to absolutely everything. Let's enforce our demands. Now I'm a recognized power, and I own all of Arabia. Except for those guys which are a protectorate of Britain, so I can't really attack them. This is because Britain and the British market are the only reason why I have such a good economy. I'm number 10 worldwide. And it's a little late, but we finally have a voting system. And also looks like the British were trying to annex Egypt. But it backfired and now the Egyptians might actually get independence. If Egypt becomes independent, then I can finally attack them. And also we have a new flag because we became a democracy. Look at that, Egypt is independent once again. Let's change that. They are fearful, will they give up? No they won't. But I'm absolutely destroying them. Let's make Egypt our vassal. Now I have a lot of infamy, but I think I can keep going into Syria. Looks like they back down. Now they are part of my empire. Let's also make Iraq join us. Okay, those guys joined. I think they were allied to Iraq before. So that means I could annex them as well. Let's finally end this war. Now I have a lot of infamy, so I'll need to wait a long time if I want to annex my subjects. And the game is running pretty slowly now, so I think this is where I'm going to end it. Thank you very much for watching, leave a like on the video, subscribe the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.